So this was a grandparents' family cruise. This was my girl's first cruise. We sailed on a 5-day, 4-night sailing on Freedom of the Seas out of Miami. My kids were so excited to board the ship, they could hardly contain their energy. Once on board, we stopped for a quick selfie and made our way up to the Windjammer Buffet, which is always a great option on embarkation day. Okay, so if you've watched my channel, you know one of my all-time favorite tips for cruising with kids is to wear your swimsuit under your embarkation day clothing. This makes it so that once you get on board and you've grabbed a quick bite to eat, you can immediately head poolside and take advantage of all the fun activities on board. My girls were really excited to ride the Flow Rider for the very first time. This is the onboard surf simulator, but there are also two pools, as well as several hot tubs, a splash pad, and several water slides. So be sure to come prepared. If you can't wear your swimsuit on board, pack your day bag with all that you need to enjoy the pool immediately upon boarding. Here at the Flow Rider, the instructor was wonderful. We chose to do the Flow Rider first because typically there is a very long wait for this ride. At times, there could be up to an hour-long wait to do the Flow Rider. Be sure to stop by the sports desk before you get in line to sign your waiver for your kids to be able to participate. Once the waiver is signed, they'll get a wristband. Participation is based on height, not weight, so do keep that in mind. My little 6-year-old was able to do the Flow Rider because she's very tall for her age, but the instructor was great, making sure that she didn't get injured and really enjoyed her time. Big Sis came along next, and she was able to really do a great job standing up. They let you try at least 3 or 4 times in a row, so if you are patient and you've got some practice, you could really get good at it very quickly. And do keep in mind, for anyone not riding the Flow Rider, there is a nice shaded space to sit over on the side and watch. After the Flow Rider, we made our way over to the pool deck. At this time, because we had boarded the ship so early, the pool deck was virtually empty, so we were able to really enjoy the pool before the crowd set in. One of the great things about Freedom of the Seas is their live reggae band. Being that I'm a first-generation Jamaican, I really appreciate good live music poolside. This band was fantastic and even entertained several requests for certain songs from the guests poolside. There was plenty of seating, plenty of chairs, and lots of shaded, comfortable loungers. After swimming, the girls were so excited to find our stateroom. We originally booked a standard ocean view cabin, but pre-cruise decided to participate in the Royal Up program. This is Royal Caribbean's bidding program, which allows you to bid any amount of money pre-cruise for any cabin category. We won our bid and were upgraded to a deluxe, spacious ocean view stateroom. We absolutely loved the stateroom. It gave us plenty of room to move about, and the floor-to-ceiling windows granted us beautiful ocean views. This cabin was all the way forward, which allowed us to have a great view of the bridge. My girls loved being able to wave to the captain from our stateroom window. After dropping our things in our room, we decided to make our way to the helipad. This area at the very forward of the ship afforded us beautiful views of downtown Miami. Miami to this day is still one of my absolute favorite cruise ports to sail away from. You get a beautiful skyline view and views of South Beach along with those beautiful mansions in the background. So we took an opportunity to take lots of pictures and just bask in the view. Night one, we decided to dine at the hibachi restaurant on board the ship. It's a really great way for families to enjoy family-style dining. We were partnered with two other families and had a show plus the best food we had all week on board the ship. So I would highly recommend the specialty dining on board Freedom of the Seas.
Almost there. A Japanese cowboy. From Spain.
So after dinner, we headed to the ice skating rink on board Freedom of the Seas to check out one of their ice skating shows. It is a very small rink, but the shows were fantastic. What the performers are able to do in such a small space. So pro tip, the Freedom of the Seas ice skating rink is actually open as part of your cruise fare for open skating for any passengers on board. And so if you really want to skate during your sailing, don't forget to pack a sweatshirt, long pants, and even socks so that you can take advantage of this wonderful amenity. After the show, the girls were so excited to check out Kids Club called Adventure Ocean.
So this is the first morning, waking up in Cocoa Key, Bahamas. And Isabel, what do we have?
An ocean view.
This thing goes out back, which is really cool.
We have floor.
And also we have a chair here.
Floor to ceiling view. Bell hanging in the corner. You're right. I think Coco Key
is on the
complete other side of the ship, but we have a beautiful ocean view.
That's the good part. If you are on the other side, you would be facing in.
And you can see nothing but ocean for miles and miles.
Yeah, there's a bird right there. Yeah.
Day two was Coco Key. We were so excited to visit this private island. It's one of my personal all-time favorites. Keep in mind, Coco Key does provide transportation shuttle service from the cruise ship along its very long pier to various stops around the island. So if you have mobility issues, if you're traveling with small children, you have a wheelchair or a stroller, certainly take advantage of this provided transportation. Otherwise, you can do like we did and just walk the pier on the way back. That's a great way to take a lot of stops, take pictures, and just enjoy the scenery.
Girls, are you excited to be at Coco Key?
Yeah, I'm in the middle.
Hold your bags.
Thank you.
So we had an absolutely wonderful day at Coco Key. We really enjoyed snorkeling and even just floating on the water. It's so calm and shallow. It's great for little ones. And we really just enjoyed our time. After that, we headed over to the pool. There's Grandma enjoying herself, having a good time. One of the things that separates Coco Key from any other cruise line's private island is they have one of the largest freshwater pools in all of the Caribbean. And so you have the access to swim up bars, lifeguards on duty, as well as zero entry into the pool from various points. You can see there are loungers around the pool. So it's a really great place to just relax for the day. We walked back to the ship as opposed to taking the tram because we wanted to get some photo ops. And you can see it was just a really picturesque place to stop and get pictures after a great day at Coco
Key. So we're leaving Coco Key. And what did you think about the day?
So fun!
You had a good day?
Yeah, I had a great day.
A great day at Coco Key.
Once back on board, we made our way back to the poolside area so the girls could go for yet another swim. We really enjoyed lounging in the pool as well as taking in all of the beautiful music from the live reggae band. As the sun set over Coco Key, it was time for us to get ready for dinner. We set sail to a beautiful sunset and we enjoyed our dinner in the main dining room. After which my kids went to Adventure Ocean and my parents and I enjoyed a Broadway show in the main theater. It was really quite entertaining. I didn't catch any video of the show, but I will say the entertainment was wonderful. The kids enjoyed Kids Club and then we went down to the main promenade for a live nightly show. After the 70s dance party, we went back to our stateroom where the girls discovered a bat towel animal. They were so surprised. Day 3 on Freedom of the Seas was a day at sea. The girls and I were so excited to explore all the other areas of the ship that we had not yet seen. So after breakfast, I made my way to the gym while the girls went to Adventure Ocean. After which we decided to check out the rock climbing wall and they had so much fun. Here they are getting all geared up in their harness. You do have to have, again, a wristband allowing you to participate, but the girls really challenged themselves and their mental and physical strength by trying to scale this wall.
Nice job, Isabel. climb up. Yep. There you go.
If you're climbing, just meet on this side.
After rock climbing, we made our way up to the top deck to check out Freedom Dunes. This is Freedom of the Seas miniature golf course. Of all the ships I've sailed, this is by far the best cruise line golf course I have ever seen. While the girls swam poolside, I made my way over to the adult-only solarium to rest and enjoy reading my book. Day 4, we were in Nassau, Bahamas. This was my parents' first time in Nassau on a cruise, so we decided to hire a private taxi to give us a little tour of the area. We checked out, of course, the famous rum factory and tried lots of samples, and then made our way around to various forts where we could see more picturesque views of the island. After exploring downtown, we took our taxi over to Paradise Island so my kids and my parents could explore the Atlantis Resort. After that, we asked our cab driver to take us to Cable Beach. Cable Beach is one of Paradise Island's free beaches. It is absolutely beautiful. There are no vendors selling food on this beach. It is a free public beach adjacent to the Atlantis Resort. So keep that in mind if you're coming for a day off of a cruise ship. You may want to pack food and snacks, as we did, in our Ziploc bags, so we had something to eat while we were relaxing on the beach. There were lots of vendors there selling water and other drinks, and of course, lots of water sports available. But keep in mind, you won't have any access to any food. Once back on board, we took our time to cool off before getting ready for dinner in the main dining room. For our final night on board Freedom of the Seas, we watched a movie poolside, and we woke up the following morning to a beautiful sunrise over downtown Miami. Thanks for sticking with us as we sailed Freedom of the Seas. I hope this helps inspire you to travel with your family and enjoy the high seas.